who are certified against non-profit criteria such as social and environmental performance, accountability and transparency. So we've gone out there for somebody to help us with this review and this work who has very strong ethical and social value credentials, and that's why we appointed them. Just on a matter of detail also, the calling notice refers to the cost that has been spent on consultants, and there's a reference to £284,000. I would really like to just highlight that for accuracy, as stated in the report, as we've heard tonight, it's the first phase of the commission that's being completed. So the work so far by BWB corresponds to the £148,000 as per the cabinet report. What I would say from an officer point of view is that we clearly look to ensure value for money and contain expenditure on external consultants and advisors where we possibly can, and that's a very serious issue that we take very seriously. Though I would highlight the fact, as referred to by the leader of the council, this is a £17 million basket of services, so the council is subsidising these services by the tune of approximately £17 million a year. So actually, the money that we've spent on consultants so far, it's a serious issue and we do it very frequently, but it does represent less than 1% of the money that we're spending on these services on an annual basis. I'd really just like to emphasise then, so we've spent quite a lot of time talking about the approach to consultation engagement tonight. I'm hoping that the approach for this this particular project, such as this, has been explained to everybody properly. Well, I think as we've heard tonight, as highlighted by Kevin Callum, you know, this first phase has very much been around developing the concept and the principle. At that very early stage, the work by BWB has focused on understanding really any of the management and operational issues and trying to get behind the customer journey, and actually the way that these services work on a day-to-day basis at the moment. As Council Facts referred to before, there's then also this important aspect around the evidence and the data gathering. And a lot of their work has been around understanding, mapping community needs, and actually talking to other commissioners across the council and partners around what wider outcomes and world-pan pleasures these services in the future might be able to support. So for a major project such as this, this has very much been that first step and that methodology for the first phase. I think we made it very clear that with this project we wanted to come back to Cabinet very, very early to share the emerging direction of that work with Cabinet, to draw attention to it with the wider public. But very importantly, it's all about the next phase when we get into the detail of that detailed work to develop the concepts and the principles, where we're actually doing that co-design approach which Kevin Callum outlined today, and certainly from the questions and the issues raised by both of the external representatives that have been here today, my professional view would be many of those kind of issues are detailed issues that will be captured in the next detailed phase as part of the work on developing a full business case. So I think this really has been an issue of timing. Very happy to take any questions that the people have.
Yes,
I'm George
Hutchinson,
Director
of about the capturing process because at the time I can only look as an example of my own friends group where we're all taking it on terms to go on holiday between now and the end of July, and I think a lot of friends groups will have people on holiday in being the summer, and I'm a bit worried that people aren't going to have enough time, and given that as the chair of the friends group has said, people's confidence is somewhat indented, though I must say, having read the document, I can't see why, but that's what's happened, and using Councillor Clarence's phrase, we are where we are. We've got groups of people who are what's happening. There seems to be a lot of misinformation gone about, and I would think that it would not be a sensible thing if we had what in fact is probably a shorter capturing period, and I would like to see it lengthened, and the whole area of holidays availability looked at. Otherwise, we will always have this hanging around us. Both sides of this room has noted that we could run into school holidays, we could run into normal holidays. And I think quite a lot of us around this table would like to make sure now to avoid calling on the specific part of time for consultation that we do have a good time. So my question is, can you assure me that you will do that when you do your capturing?
Okay, through you, Chair, I'll avoid the one word answer, which would be yes. I think it's a very pertinent issue, and just a few points really. So first of all, it is fair to say that we have had to down tools on this project because of this call. So in terms of detailed planning around the project, we've not been able to do that yet. But what I can say from the preliminary discussions that we've been able to have in terms of just very outline planning, what the next phase consists of would be this work to develop the full business case. Importantly, that work is led by the council and the work is carried out by council officers. So BWB and that technical expertise supports us, but the council lead the full business case and ultimately what comes back to cabinet. As Kev said before, very importantly, the consultation process as well will also be fronted up and led by the council and council officers. We've started to do some very high level planning of outline tasks in the next phase that we've been able to do, bearing in mind we've got the call in. And from that assessment of the outline tasks, we are confident that we can carry out this next phase of detailed co-design consultation engagements, do that in a robust manner, and come back with a full business case report to Cabinet for October time. It's a very pertinent issue that you raise. For many of us that have been with the council for many years, we've done projects before that have been around about this time in the year, and sometimes we've been doing work and then we've moved into the summer break and the summer recess, which isn't the time to consult. And that has been a factor when we have been making that assessment of the tasks on us erring on the cautious side of suggesting that we're looking at a October cabinet cycle rather than a September cabinet cycle. And what we can actually do, we need to move quickly, but we have got that period of time to make sure that we're out there consulting, engaging fully, and then running into September before we then look to come back to cabinet. So I'm comfortable from all the information that we have available that working to that October original timeline, we're going to be able to do a comprehensive job. Through you, Chair, I think if we are coming back to the shared intelligence work and the cost of that, I would like to just make some comments on that. So really then, just as a reminder, really just to clarify the position, the core purpose of the shared intelligence work has been to look at the strategic alignment between the library service and the rural plan, and opportunities to improve the achievement of key outcomes via the service. This has involved looking at patterns of socio-economic need and how usage of the current service compares with this need. The consultant was also invited to provide views as to what an effective library service might look like. And as picked up by the press, this is inevitably involved in comparison with other high-performing authorities in this field that deliver a more effective service with fewer buildings. So we've had views that way, but importantly, the primary purpose of that was to feed into the broader piece of work being carried out by BWB. Certainly from the start, based on the history and the issues around libraries in the past, it's been deemed entirely appropriate, worthwhile and prudent to seek a totally independent upstream assessment of library provision by experts in this particular field that could then review into that further process. So that £23,000 in my view has been a very worthwhile expenditure to give us that independent assessment of the library service, bearing in mind the history and bearing in mind, as we touched on before, the fact that we do have that statutory context around providing a comprehensive and efficient service. So that work was produced by Shared Intelligence. Most importantly, the work was shared with BWB and with this project. So that was the, you know, the primary purpose and the means to that end.
Sorry, just to come back on that. So from the beginning, we knew that before Shared Intelligence were brought in, we knew that BWB before Shared Intelligence were going to be here, and Shared Intelligence was just going to be fed into that. Because in all the conversations that I've had with the director of transformation, that was never made clear at all. I don't think anyone in this room would have known that. Shared Intelligence was always seen as a separate report that we were going to get back last year, and as the chair of the back of the room, we used to chair this committee, knows it just kept getting kicked back. Oh, we've got another report coming, we've got another report coming. This was never made clear, so it comes back to the communication, doesn't it? Again, about what is the process, which reports are going to feed into where is consultation going to come in. So, do you think that the real failing is not the communication hasn't been there about how all this is going to come together? I know it's in this report, the opposition.
There may be some learning points about how we've communicated our approach, but just to be clear, the shared intelligence work that was commissioned last autumn, it was commissioned with a specific purpose to get that upstream independent assessment service around the issues facing just the library service and looking at the future potential role of the library service and how it could meet the needs of our communities and the pledges and the outcomes in the rural plan. That was the primary piece of work purely for that. From my point of view, from my involvement in the project, it's always been recognised that the work was in that context. Inevitably, the shared intelligence work wasn't to develop the final solution or a change in solution for service delivery. It was that independent upstream assessment.
So I just make the point clear there. The shared intelligence, I'm not disputing the reasons behind doing it. Yeah. What I'm asking is, was it the fact that BWB was always in place before we did the shared intelligence, and it was always the case that that was going to feed into that? Because I thought BWB were commissioned after the shared intelligence. I don't know if I'm missing something here. I'm not saying that you've not used it afterwards, you found the use after the fact. I'm not disputing that. But at the time, you seem to be intimating that it was for that purpose, that it was for the use of BWB. And I thought the time, you know, the timeline was not in that order.
I think there's been a desire to commission that shared intelligence review. Obviously, at the time, I wasn't involved in that function of the council that was on the timing of that stage. So it was before we moved to the new operating model. All I can say is that we've then commissioned BWB to then do that concept principle work. And it's been, you know, in common sense, it's been sensible that we feed that other work in as well. So in terms of the precise timings of the commission and some of that context before, unfortunately, Chair, I genuinely couldn't comment on that. All I can say is that I've given a very clear perspective from, you know, November, December onwards when I've been in my role for this project. I think, you know, just to say, you know, without being dependent, I think some of that timing is academic. We've had a robust
useful piece of work by Shared Intelligence. That's given us some views, and now those technical views and opinions, we respect what they are, we will just look to feed them into the next phase and give them due consideration.
Sorry, I'm afraid to talk to you before. Knowing how these things work, I presume in your role as the lead officer, you will have briefly in the past leadership of the Conservative Group or the present leadership of the Conservative Group at some point during this process. If you remember when it was, that may be useful, but the fact, the question I'm trying to tease out, did the leadership, whoever it was at the time, ask for their group to be given a full briefing on the scoping document, which is what happened at the Labour Group?
For you, Chair, in terms of party briefings, the only comment I can make is that, as per the usual process, in advance of the Cabinet of the 27th of March, I understand it wasn't me personally, but I understand another officer provided a briefing to the Conservative Group, as would normally happen in advance of any report to cabinet, as is common practice.
The shared intelligence thing, because I don't know if you realize, but Steve, we've been arguing and discussing these lines for about 3 years, haven't we? On the last committee.
It's very important.
It is. Before it was the new model that was introduced. So is that the report we were waiting for to decide what we were going to provide as a library offer to Wirral? Because I can't understand it. See, what I'm trying to get my head around is we've got consultants telling us how we're doing an assessment of what it already is, but we still don't know what it is we're supposed to be trying to provide. So if we don't know what we're going to provide as a library service, how can we then go in 5 weeks to all these people and say, what is it you want? They'll say bells and whistles. What happens if everybody wants everything? What then?
For you, Chair, this is precisely why we're following this methodology for this project. Before going into detailed consultation engagement, it's about getting a proper understanding, collating the evidence, collating the data, understanding the typical customer journey as the services are now, understanding the Wirral Plan pledges, the outcomes that we're trying to achieve, all of those social value aspects. That's the reason why we are, why we've done that as an important first step. To start the very first step of highlighting in the future, the library service, what role could it play, what opportunities are there in support of our communities, their needs and the outcomes of the Wirral Plan. So I think that question, really provides the opportunity to explain why we're using this methodology.
Right, and that methodology that, as I said to you before, well, not to you, but as I mentioned before, I attended two of these consultations, whatever you want to call them, it was just me and I'm sitting in the same library. And I asked them questions about how they were getting that information, because it was an information gathering point. And they can only then do footfall for things like people who take out books, because it's recorded, people who log onto the system, because it's recorded, and that is the basis of what their usage of the libraries are. It didn't take into account all the baby bouncing and all the rest of the stuff that goes on. It didn't.
Chair, without wavering from the scope of the call in this evening, which is about the approach to consultation engagement and understanding, my view would be